In this lesson, we will discuss if-then-else structures. When you want your program to execute certain statements if a test condition is true, and other statements if the test condition is false, you can use an if-then-else structure. If the test condition is true, only the statements between the if and else will be executed. If the test condition is false, only the statements between the else and end if will be executed. In this example, an if-then-else structure is used to help the user decide whether he or she should buy a pizza. After running this program, two message boxes will appear. The first message box states the pizza is too expensive, and the second message box states X is 700. Let's examine why these messages appear. The variables cost pizza and X are given double data types, and cost pizza is assigned the value 11. Cost pizza is a variable that will store the price of a pizza, and X is a variable that is used to help demonstrate how if-then-else structures work. There's a test condition at the beginning of the if-then-else structure. Is cost pizza greater than 10? Is 11 greater than 10? True. So all statements between the if and else are executed. A message box displays the pizza is too expensive, and X is assigned the value 700. We reach else and then jump to the end if statement. The statements between else and end if are ignored. Finally, a message box displays X is and the current value of X, which is 700. Let's see what will happen if cost pizza is assigned the value 9 instead of 11. When we run this program, two message boxes will appear. The first states buy the pizza, and the second states X is 22. As before, we create two double variables named cost pizza and X. And now cost pizza is assigned the value 9. The test condition cost pizza greater than 10 is evaluated. Is 9 greater than 10? This is false, so we skip the statements between if and else and only execute the statements between else and end if. A message box displays buy the pizza, and X is assigned the value 22. The if-then-else structure ends with the end if statement, and a message box displays the current value of X, which is 22. Notice how the use of indentation inside the if structure allows the user to quickly figure out which statements will be executed if the test condition is true and which statements will be executed if the test condition is false.